Making new presets of devices in Live is a really easy process. In this video, we're going to look at how you can make the presets and save them to your user library. In track number 5, I have an instrument rack. This instrument rack contains several different devices, and I've mapped some of the important parameters to macros. I'd like to save this instrument rack as a preset to my user library. To do this, I'll click the Save icon on the instrument rack. This action will immediately refer me to my user library. I can rename the device and then press Enter on my computer keyboard to save it. The preset is also saved in a subfolder labeled Instrument Rack. Any devices or clips that you save from a live set will be saved to their respective folders in the user library. If you right-click anything in the user library, you can use collections to further tag your sounds and clips so you can find them more easily from your browser. I'd like to save another preset from the kick that I'm using in my current live set. I'll select the track with the kick and click the save icon of the device to save it to my user library. I'll rename this preset and then click enter to save it. As you can see, this has been saved to another section of the user library. I'll use the collections feature again so that I can quickly access it from my browser. In addition to saving your own presets and clips, the user library also contains additional folders for your defaults, grooves, and samples that have been imported or recorded into live sets or projects. I'll now go to the Collections section in my browser to load the chords preset that I created earlier. I can simply do this by dragging and dropping the preset into an empty space in my session view. If for any reason you need to locate your user library, go to Live's Preferences, and under the tab Library, under the section Content Locations, you can reference the directory location to find your user library. If for any reason you need to relocate your user library, click Browse to locate this on your computer, and then press OK to confirm this.